no respect at all. When I was a baby, I was breastfed by my father.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rodney.
This is my moment when fate took my hand. But once in a lifetime, I can't sing. What the hell am I singing for, huh? I'll be doing card tricks next, weather reports, whatever you want. But it's nice seeing some folks here tonight from television, tell you that. The one guy gave me a hard time. He kept looking at me and looking at me. He said, what I know you from, you know? I said, you ever watch a Tonight Show, Johnny Carson? He said, yeah, you too. Hey, good crowd, huh? It's all right. You know me, I love crowds. I love crowds. And as a kid, my house was always crowded, always people around. You know, I come from a big old-fashioned, hard-working, stupid family. That's what I come from. What a dumb family I got. Are you kidding? Last week, I looked up my family tree. I found out I'm the sap. My old man, he was dumb too, my old man. He worked in a bank. They caught him stealing pens. I tell you, I can't relax, you know? Well, the other night, I felt like having a few drinks. I went over to the bartender. I said, surprise me. He showed me a naked picture of my wife. My wife, I got no sex life either. She cut me down once a month. No, I'm lucky. Two guys I know, she cut out completely. Look, I met one of the guys. I told him, who told you could fool around my wife? He said, everybody. My wife. Well, last night, she told me she wants to have sex in the back seat of the car, and she wants me to drive. A good laugh, we even trying out. You're a good laugher here, baby. How you doing? I love a guy with a good laugh. You're all right, baby. Huh? Where you from, bud? The questions get hotter as I go along. You know? I'm not going to follow you home. What are you worrying about for crying out loud, huh? Where you from again? Whereabouts? Jersey? No wonder. I've got enough trouble over here. Don't you start now. Will you please? Whereabouts in Jersey, huh? Wayne, New Jersey. Oh, Wayne. Oh, you city slicker. I'm in a good mood, though, I'll tell you that. I just signed a big contract with General Motors for 2 years. I bought a new car. I always get stuck when I buy a car. The salesman always says she's a beauty. He never says he's a beauty, and I found out why, because a car and a girl are very much alike. I mean, with either one, a car or a girl, how many times in a cold morning when you really need it, it won't turn over? What the hell? Nice to see the love in the room, anyway. Man, there's too much hate in the world today. People always fight with each other. It's awful. You know? The trouble with me is I'm too easygoing. And last night I had dinner in a Chinese restaurant. I opened my fortune cookie. Inside was a guy's check next to me. I said to my buddy, I got your check. He said, thanks. You know, I mean, it's wise guys. You take a little vacation. It's put to some guy who works in a travel agency. He told me I could spend 6 nights in Puerto Rico. No days, just 6 nights in Puerto Rico. I said to myself, well, I do myself days. You do whatever you want. Just keep out of Puerto Rico. Well, you have to get away once in a while, take a little vacation. I went to Paris last year. In Paris. Are you folks been to Paris? How about Pennsylvania? Well, I guess Pennsylvania is more popular than Paris. What am I? I like to get away once in a while. What the heck? I just did a one-nighter in Milwaukee, and she was lovely. I wish I came to the Midwest, and I lived in a nice, adjusted town. You know, really, it was nice. I had a wooden frame house with a screen door in the back of the kitchen. My brother and sister were Marianne and Biff. I had a fat maid named Annie. I walk her with a tennis racket, smack her in the ass. She goes, oh, that boy. And Dad worked for the bank for 30 years. Vice president, very adjusted man, Dad. Churchgoer, never smokes, drinks, or gambles. Then you read about these guys. What, did they pick up an axe and wipe out the whole family, you know? And the next day, the cops come around. What happened here? What kind of man was he? He was a quiet man. A very quiet man. Where was I? Oh, I was in Paris. Yes, I was in Paris. Went to a place called the Crazy Horse Saloon. Little French girl saw me there. There's the owner right over there. I'm going to see her. A little French girl saw me. She looked at me. She said, you're cute. And then she told me you're medicamented best lovers. And then she said, well, you're medicamented comedians are the best lovers. And I walked away. I figured I was too good for her. Who the hell needs that? She's a lovely girl, though. She told me she was a world traveler. Then she told me what a trip cost, and I told her we live in two different worlds. She was a lovely girl. In fact, that night took me to a wild party. I played a new version of Russian roulette. You know, we passed around six girls, and one of them had VD. I don't know. People say to me, what do you like about a girl that goes legs? Are you a leg man? Are you a breast man? Are you an ass man? I don't know what I am. And I think I must be an ass man, you know? Yeah, people always say to me, you're an ass man. I'll tell you what's embarrassing. You see a great ass, you follow it, it turns out to be a guy. Am I too fast for this whole table over here? What is it, huh? There's a lot of things I can't figure out. I was in a place the other night, and this place was girls dancing. They were no clothes on, naked. And they wouldn't let me in. I didn't have a tie and a jacket. Oh, yesterday was a beauty. I asked a cab driver, where can I get some action? He took me to my house. There's a lot of things going on around my house. Well, the other night in front of my house, I saw a guy jogging naked. I said to him, how come? He said, because you came home early. Well, last week I really got stuck. I went to a discount massage parlor with self-service. I'll tell you, my sex life had nothing anyway. You kidding? My sex life. My biggest thrill is self-inflicted hickeys. What a sex life. I told a girl from Allstate, what I want to put in your hands, you'll never sell me insurance. What a sex life. The only reason I get any girls at all is because of who I am, a rapist. I'm not a sexy guy. No, I'm not sexy. Well, this morning when I put on my underwear, I could hear the Fruit of Loom guys giggling. I'm a bad lover. You're kidding? Very bad lover. You know, I caught a peeping Tom booing me. No, but some guys, they do anything to get girls. I was trying to get girls. Well, I was taking my dog for a walk. I figured some girls say, oh, what a cute dog. Before you start talking, you get the girl. Didn't work out. My dog is too smart, you know. He was using me to go to the dogs. No, but dogs are smart, they really are. I mean, a guy meets a girl, he's not sure if he likes her, takes her out a few times, spends all kinds of money. A dog don't do this. Dog goes out with one smell. She's for me, knows right away, you know? Yeah, but women have a lot of control, I'll tell you that. You know? I can tell when they go to ladies' room. You know, a woman never goes and she has to go. She always goes and someone else has to go. I hear them talk. I don't care. I'll go now, later, whenever you have to go. How do I do that? I have no idea. A lot of women act so classy. They never say, I'm going to the bathroom. They have to powder my nose. That's where her nose is. In a lot of trouble, I'll tell you that. Now, I'll tell you a place you have to control yourself in a bank, but a lot of banks never see a men's room. They have men's rooms only for the employees. You have to work there to use it. I was at the bank last week. I had to go so bad, I applied for a job. But it's nice when you borrow money from a bank. You know, if you miss a payment, you get notices like, have you forgotten us? Perhaps we crossed in the mail or something. You know, you borrow money from a Shylock is different. As a kid, I bought $100 from a Shylock. I paid him back $20 a week for 5 years. I still owed him $450. Now, how the hell I work out? Now, you do a lot of things. You're coming out of kidney when I'm getting older now. I know I'm getting older. I'm at the age now, to me, shooting up means the enema bag. Shouldn't get old. At my age, I want two girls at once. If I fall asleep, they got each other to talk to. You know when you get old, you get certain signs. I walked past a cemetery, two guys ran after me with shovels. Nah, I don't care about sex anymore. To me, food is exciting. Nah, I tell you what, me, eating has replaced sex completely. In fact, I had a mirror put in over my kitchen table. Oh, the other night I was embarrassed. While I was eating, my kid walked in. I grabbed my napkin, I covered my main dish, you know? Well, my wife had a mirror put in over our bed. Yeah, she told me she likes to watch herself laugh. I don't know. I tell you, I'm the kind of guy with me, I'll tell you, certain times I like sex, you know, like after a cigarette. Well, my wife is different. After we have sex, she never wants a cigarette. She says one drag is enough. I gotta lose some weight, I'll tell you that. I lost some weight, gotta lose some weight. You know, that's a rough one, weight, isn't it? Every damn day is a battle with weight. I was heavy, though. I was fat, you kid. I was so fat when I got my shoes shined. I had to take the guy's word for it. You see, these are all known as jokes, what I'm doing here. They're called jokes. You got that straight? Okay, we'll work it out, all right? This guy look at me like I'm a dog act for crying out. I don't know. I tell you what, me, nothing comes easy, nothing. Well, last week I went to the track, I showed off the opening gun, they killed my horse. I'll tell you my trouble, I got the wrong doctor. You know my doctor, Dr. Vinnie Boombach. That's my doctor. You know the doctor? Well, that doctor, forget it, weird. I saw him last week, I told him, Doc, every day I wake up, I look in the mirror, I want to throw up, what's wrong with me? He said, I don't know, but your eyesight is perfect. I went to my court, I swallowed a bottle of sleeping pills. He told me to have a few drinks and get some rest. Oh, he's a strange doctor, you know. No matter where it hurts you, he wants to kiss it, make it better. Well, after he checked me for a hernia, I had to change my phone number. He didn't help me lose weight either. He told me to run 5 miles a day for 2 weeks. I called him up. I said, Doc, I'm 70 miles from my house. This table can't multiply either. He got a multiply over here, okay? My dentist, too, that's another one. I told him my teeth are all getting yellow. He told me to wear a brown necktie. Well, I'll tell you, I never had any luck with doctors. I found out my proctologist, he used to work for Roto-Rooter. I wish everyone knew what a proctologist was. It'd be a hell of a joke, you know? You never heard of Roto-Rooter, right? I'll tell you, last week was a rough week. My psychiatrist told me I'm going crazy. I said to him, if you don't mind, I'd like a second opinion. He said, all right, you're ugly too. He told me to lay on the couch face down. You kid, I know I'm ugly. I stuck my head out the window, got arrested for mooning. I was an ugly kid, too. I worked in a pet store. People kept asking how big I'd get. I wanted you to try to make me a poster boy for birth control. What a childhood I had. My mother never breastfed me. She told me she liked me as a friend. My mother had morning sickness after I was born. My old man, he didn't like my looks either. He carried around a picture of the kid who came with the wallet. Did a lot of things, my old man. You kidding? My old man, on Halloween, he told me to put jockey shorts on my head and go as an ass. You're all right. You're a nice group out there. I'll tell you that. You're okay there, folks. You're all right. You're all right. Thank you very much. You're okay. Thank you very much. You're a classy crowd, too. I can see that, you know. Well, you gotta have a touch of class, you know. You know what real class is? When you're alone and you fart, you say, excuse me. That's class. Well, I'm glad you're a good crowd, too. Big producer here tonight from Sausalito. Ooh, that's a great name if you're gay, isn't it? Sausalito. A lot of S's and T's in it, you know. I got a cousin who's gay. I was kidding. I tell him in the family tree, he's in the fruit section, you know. My cousin went to London. He was so disappointed. He found out Big Ben was a clock. Oh, I knew my cousin was strange in high school. Other kids were dissecting frogs. He was opening flies. What, do you want to fight now? Now, you kidding? Being gay can happen to anybody. You kid, it could happen to you. It could happen to you. Oh, it did happen to you. Hi there. You're a good sport, so you're all right. You're okay. But it's good to see you back in men's clothes again, I'll tell you that. Oh, what can I tell you? It's tough to be funny when you're coming off drugs, I'll tell you that. I tried marijuana just once. That's all, just once. I didn't know what I was doing. I was on cocaine. When you're on cocaine, you don't know what you're doing. I was in a restaurant, I tried to snort the sugar off my cornflakes. And kids today, they're into cocaine. Ooh, kids today, they don't want to read about Snow White. They want to shove it up their nose. I tried marijuana, I got too hungry though. Ooh, was I hungry? I was so hungry, I smoked a half a joint and I ate the other half. I was starving, you know? Sometimes you turn to drugs, the pressure of life reaches you, you know? And my life is nothing but pressure, all pressure. And this pressure is like a heaviness. And it's always on top of me, this heaviness, always there since I'm a kid. Other people wake up in the morning, ah, new day, up and at 'em. I wake up, the heaviness is waiting for me, nice. And sometimes I even talk to it. And I say, hi, heaviness. And the heaviness looks back at me, today you're gonna get it good, you know. You'll be drinking early today. And I don't wanna drink, I'm a bad drinker. When I drink the next day, I gotta do two things. I try and locate my car, and I gotta bring back the car I took. I'm a bad drinker. bad drinker. You know you're drunk when you take a leak and your fly isn't open, I'll tell you that. When I drink, I don't know what I'm doing. I got loaded in Vegas one night. I shot dice. I lost $1,000. I got even though I stole 400 sweet and lows. I got gambling in Atlantic City now, too. Pretty soon we'll be gambling in New York, you know? How many people here think you should be gambling in New York? Yeah. How many here think you should not be gambling in New York? How many here don't give a shit? You look like a don't give a shit crowd, you know that? I like to gamble. I can lose a few bucks. I'm doing okay today. What the heck? As a kid, I had nothing. I was poor, really poor. I was so poor, my rich aunt died in a will. I owed her $20. I was poor. I wore my father's hand-me-downs. It was rough. I had to unzip my fly to blow my nose. We were poor. Why, in our Christmas tree, we had no tinsel. We used to wait for Grandpa to sneeze. Oh, it's a funny line. Don't give me that bullshit, all right? I've been through enough of my life. As a kid, I had plenty of pimples, too. One day, I fell asleep in the library. I woke up, a blind man was reading my face. You're kidding. I went through plenty. What a face to my hitchhike that got beat up. I used the wrong finger. You're kidding. I had it rough. I never went to college. My old man had other ideas. He told me to get a job and make sure the boss is taller than I am. That way it'd be easy for me to kiss his ass. I don't know. With kids today, it's different. They got a two-good. They don't appreciate it either. Last Christmas, my kid wanted a BB gun. I gave him a BB gun. He gave me a sweatshirt with a bullseye on the back. What a smart kid I got. The other day, I told him about the birds and the bees. He told me about my wife and a butcher. My kid, he drives me nuts. Well, he put crazy glue in my Preparation H. I mean, I got a real mean kid. Well, he scotch tapes worms to the sidewalk, then watches the birds get hernias. My daughter, too, she's no bargain either. In public school, she was voted most likely to conceive. That's the trouble with kids today. They play around so young. Ooh, they play around too young, you know? Well, today they got birth control pills shaped like Fred Flintstone. Well, you talk to some kids, they're afraid to have sex. They're scared. I mean, the first time I had sex, I was scared the first time. Ooh, was I scared? I was all alone. I'll tell you one thing, though, my kids are good looking. I got good looking kids. Ooh, thank God my wife cheats on me, you know? Nah, with kids, nobody wins. You kidding, kids? They never turn out the way you want. That's why today you see so many misfit sons working for their fathers, you know. And these sons all sound the same, you know. Yeah, my dad and I are in business with my dad. Actually, my father's father, he started a business, which is a good thing, too, because my dad and my son were both fucking idiots, you know, sure. I don't know. It's tough to work it out, folks. What can I tell you? I got a dog, too. He drives me nuts. His favorite bone is in my arm. A dog. Well, last night, 4 times he went in the paper. 3 times I was reading it. I got a dumb dog. Every time he sees me, he has a love affair at my leg. And I'm getting a like it, too, I'll tell you that. Well, the other night I came home loaded, I was looking for his leg. I got a female dog. She gives me trouble, too. I try to mate her. She wants 50 biscuits. Now, that's enough talk about sex. What are you here today? Sex? I'll tell you the truth with sex. I had it up to here. Not lately, though, I'll tell you that. Am I too deep for this whole section over here, too? At least I got enough problems. My car broke down, you know. I got a car, I got nothing but trouble. And every Sunday, I take my family out for a push. I'll tell you, with my car, when I'm on a road, just once, like to see someone pass me without pointing to one of my tires. And I went out last week, I bought the perfect second car, a tow truck. And I always get lost, too. When I get lost, I'm lost. Other people get lost, they get directions. Go straight ahead, follow your nose, just follow your nose. No one ever tells me to follow my nose. I always hear things like, you're way off. Not in this town. Then they give me directions, I get lost all over again. Go to your sixth light, make a right turn. As soon as I pull away, I'm in trouble. I never know if I should count the first light. Or else they tell me to go straight ahead. Chemist, go straight ahead. As soon as I pull away, I come to a fork in the road. Didn't happen to you, too? What can I tell you? The last time my wife drove the car, she cracked it up, too, went into a tree. Told me it wasn't her fault. She blew the horn. Well, the first time she drove the car, she hit a deer. It was in a zoo. Now, my wife isn't too smart, you know. One night she went out, some guy stole a car. I said to her, you see what he looked like? She told me she got the license plate number. I mean, she's not smart at all. I told her our kid is spoiled. She told me a lot of kids smell that way. Nah, she's not smart at all. You kid, what, the second time she got pregnant, she thought we had to get married again, you know? Ooh, I really got stuck last week. I bought a new book, 100 Ways to Make Love. I ended up in Traction. It was a misprint. I mean, there's always something. My wife's father, he just moved in too, has electronic pacemaker. Every time he sneezes, the garage door opens. I mean, today's been a terrible day. Got up this morning, picked up my shirt, a button fell off. A briefcase, the handle fell off. I'm afraid to go to the bathroom. I mean, things happen to me you wouldn't believe. It's a weird feeling to be standing in a men's room, you see your home phone up on the wall. I mean, another works out. Last night, a hooker told me she had a headache. You don't know what a hooker is either, huh? Got you girls over here, you know what a hooker is? Oh, you are hookers. Oh, good luck to you. I'm just kidding, joshing around. Are you? God, and you, sir, take your hand off your peepee. You go blind that way. That's why you're not laughing. You're too busy down there. I can say hooker and peepee. I'm not on television. It's a nightclub. You can say whatever you want here. This son of a bitch, bullshit, bastard. What the hell am I sweating for? It's my joint. I got the job. I don't know what I'm doing here. You know what I mean? All right. That's okay. It's just a hobby. That's all a hobby. I work there for laughs, you know. I make my money at my regular job. I sing the national anthem at cockfights. What do you say we bust up this joint, huh? All right, next week, after the fire. Now, when I started in showbiz, I worked only tough places, places like Fonzo's Knuckle Room, Aldo's, formerly Vito's, formerly Nunzio's. Ooh, that was a tough one, Nunzio's tough. I sat down to eat in a menu that had broken leg of lamb. And Nunzio, he was tough. And then he said to me, kid, you want to go hunting? I said, okay, I'm game, and he shot me. And showbiz is tough, too, I'll tell you that. Boy, what a racket. You don't know what you go through in showbiz. You kid, showbiz is... you know, sometimes I think back of all the women I had to sleep with to get where I got, you know that? It's a tough racket. You couldn't last week my fan club broke up, the guy died. In fact, I met a new agent last week, a woman agent. She asked me if I had an 8x10. I told her if I had an 8x10, I wouldn't have to work anymore. I never got girls when I was a kid in showbiz. I never got girls. One time I took out a college girl. And she majored in business psychology. For $100, she'll blow your mind. I can't make it with chicks. You go out with now, you're going to start conversations. Hi, where are you from? Really? What sign are you? Ha, ha, ha. I can't do it. To me, the 8 hours of bullshit ain't worth the 8 seconds. I can't make the whole trip. I'll tell you that. I'll tell you what's tough. You spend a whole night with a chicken and daylight comes and you didn't. Oh, death, where is thy sting? I don't know. No, but I never got girls. I was making love to one girl. She started to cry. I said to her, you'll hate yourself in the morning. She said, no, I hate myself now. This girl was no bargain either. Showed up, she had pigtails under her arms. She was fat, too. She got in a scale. A card came out and said, one at a time. This girl was fat and ugly. Ooh, she ugly. How ugly? She was known as a two-bagger. And that's a girl who's so ugly, go out with her, you put a bag over your head in case the bag over her head breaks. She was ugly. She was so ugly, you look in a dictionary under the word ugly, you see her picture. I mean, ugly. Kidding? Oh, I bent down to pet her cat, it was the hair in her legs. It's an ugly chick. I took her to the top of the Empire State Building airplane and started to attack her. I mean, ugly. I found out when she goes to the bank, they turn off the cameras. You kidding? The ugly girl. Hey, well, two guys broke in her apartment. She yelled rape. They yelled, no! My looks don't mean nothing. I got a niece, an ugly girl, and she got married. She's happy. She married an ugly guy, you know. Today, they got two very ugly kids. In fact, they're all so ugly in a family album. They only keep the negatives. I'm not waiting for you, okay? It's nice to hear you laugh, though, I'll tell you that. Because there either there's no laughs. I live in New York here in the West Side, a very bad neighborhood. Just last week, a guy pulled a knife on me. I could see it wasn't a real professional job. There was butter on it. What a neighborhood. What a first day I moved in, I asked a cop, I said, how long I walked to the subway? He said, I don't know, so far, no one ever made it. It's getting worse over there. I just put some new sidewalk in front of my building. Remember when I was a kid, I put my handprint in a wet cement? I forgot to do it again. I tell you, it's a weird feeling, put your hand in cement, and you feel another hand. Oh, there's nothing but killings over there. I went out, I bought a waterbed. There was a guy at the bottom of it. My apartment, nothing but robberies. They're all over the place. Every time I close a window, I hit somebody's fingers. When I was a kid, I once turned to crime, you know. I pulled one job and they caught me. I was so stupid, you know. I picked the guy's pocket in an airplane, made a run for it. My kid goes to the worst school there is. Only public school I know, the school newspaper, has an obituary column. Yeah, I looked at one class that teach the kids English. I heard a teacher say, what comes after a sentence? Kid yelled out, you make an appeal. That's where I live, in the West Side. I live in an older building. I live in a kind of building like I take a shower. I never get under it right away. First 5 minutes, I get rust. And while I'm taking a shower, if someone in the building takes a cold drink of water, I get burnt. You know, I want to move out of it. My wife wants to stay there, though. My wife, she can't do nothing right, nothing, you know? I took her to the ballet. She forgot the sandwiches. She can't cook either. The worst cook in the world. In my house, we pray after we eat. What a lousy cook, you kid. I don't think meatloaf should glow in the dark. I got the only dog, he begs for Alka-Seltzer. She can't cook at all. I leave dental floss in the kitchen, the roaches hang themselves. Well, last night she gave me a steak, it still had marks where the jockey was hitting it. And then she told me to take out the garbage. I told her, you cooked it, you take it out. I tell you, my wife always gave me trouble, always. At my bachelor party, she was in the movie. It's tough to stay married, it's tough. Are you kidding? My wife, during sex, she always wants to talk to me. Yeah, the other night she called me from a hotel. I mean, sex with me, that's ridiculous. My wife makes love to me, there's always a reason for it. One night she used me to time an egg. I don't know, I'm getting very confused, I'll tell you that, very confused. There's a lot of people confused today, you know. You want to really confuse a guy? Join him while he's taking a leak in the street. If you want to drive nuts all together, have your wife and kids join him too, he'll really go crazy, you know? I went nuts last week, and I tried group sex. Now I got a new problem, I don't know who to thank. Group sex, and I got divorced. That was group sex. My wife screwed me in front of the jury. Anybody got any good drugs here, perhaps? You get older, you look for ways to relax, you know. Doctors tell you don't smoke, don't drink, eat certain foods. At my age, what I can look forward to. But from this point on, if I take excellent care of myself, I'll get very sick and die. What am I doing? I should be home and slippers relaxing, creating hatred in the family. My age, I should be reading the papers. I'm looking to roll them. You know when you're really old? When your family talks about you in front of you. Ever see those families? The guy's sitting right there. What do you want to do with Pop? I mean, Pop can't stay here. And Pop just sits there dribbling. Now, Harry, put Pop in the garage. We got company coming, okay? That's when you're old. I'm glad you got a sense of humor. This world is too much. You got to have a laugh once in a while. That's why the Polish people are okay. Got a sense of humor. Do jokes. They kid around. They're all right. What's that? You go to the movies. You talk back to the screen. Take it easy, will you? You want to save your breath. You need it later to blow up your inflatable date. No offense. I gotta tell you, we got stuff to work out. I was trying to tell you, that's why the Polish people are okay. Got a sense of humor. They do jokes. They kid around. Where's the Polish people, huh? Over there, good to see you, baby. How are you? Where you from, buddy?
Warsaw.
You're from Warsaw. It's a long walk, isn't it, huh? I hear about the Polish guy, won a gold medal, he had it bronzed. Oh, I met a guy last week with a problem, half Polish, half Italian. He wants to beat someone up, he forgot who. I got my own problems. I'm half Jewish and half Japanese. In fact, I was circumcised at Benihana's. What a life. Are you a kid? I don't know who to believe anymore. May they say, love thy neighbor as thyself. What am I supposed to do, jerk him off too? I hear about the Polish guy left his keys in the car, had to get a hanger to get his family out. I'll tell you what. You're a hot crowd. Ready for this one? This Polish guy, they found sugar in his urine. He went home and took a leak over his cornflakes. Glad to see you appreciate sophisticated humor. Look how I ended up at my age, huh? Sweating, telling dirty Polish jokes. How old am I? How old do you think I am? Over 21, yes. Thank you very much. I'm 58 years old. That's how old I am, 58. I don't look it. I know I don't look it, huh? No, people think I'm younger. They really do. They think I'm younger. In fact, every girl I meet takes me for 50. 58. Are you kidding? I could go tomorrow. And I hope I go tomorrow. I haven't gone today yet. Maybe you want to ask me some questions. You're a nice, lively group here. People always ask me questions about life, showbiz, whatever. Hey, Bobby, put up all the lights, okay? All the lights up. Anybody got a question? Hey, anybody got a cigarette here? Nobody smokes. I'm the only fool around here. You got a cigarette? Thanks very much. I left mine in the machine. You know how it is. Thank you. You got a match, too? I don't do magic up here. I got a crazy doctor who told me to keep smoking if I want to stop chewing gum, so what the hell? Anybody got a question here, perhaps? How's my health? My health is very bad, very bad. You kidding? This morning I fixed myself pretty good too. This morning, my push-ups in the nude. I didn't see the mousetrap. You have a question here, so yes. Did my mother have any kids that lived? You're a hot shit too, you know that, sir? A lot of laughs. You have a question, sir?
What do you do for a living?
What do I do for a living? That's nice too. I get guys for your sister, okay? There was some wise guy. He's a wise. Be a wise guy. After the show, you and I go to a men's room and have it out together. I'll show you how small you are. From now on, I want questions only from people. Yes, my dear, you have a question. I'm lucky if I can find it in the morning. You kidding? Told you, I'm getting old. At my age, I'm envious of a stiff wind. Any other questions here, perhaps?
Hey, Rodney.
Yes?
I give you a kiss if you give me your tie.
You'll give me a kiss if I give you my tie. That's not a bad offer.
Take it.
What do I get for my shorts? Yes, right in the back there. I was born in Babylon, Long Island. You hear that place?
Yeah.
Very small little town. Very small town. So small the local hooker was a virgin. Very small place. One day I plugged in my electric razor and a trolley stopped. Yes, sir.
It's Johnny Carson, really like.
Johnny Carson's a great guy. He really is. Ed McMahon is gay, though, you know. But Carson's a great guy. No, Carson's a great guy. Yes, sir.
Did you get any respect in high school?
No respect at all. I used to share a locker with a mop. Yes.
Do you have any children?
Yes, I have three children, one of each.
No, I have a boy in college. He's majoring in fucking up. That boy. I only wish his room was as clean as his pot. They sent him home last week for lewd behavior. The kid took 10 lewds. Over there, yes. Never, 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 never. You from Brooklyn, huh, baby? Nice to have class in the room, I'll tell you that, boy. It's all right. Hey, Brooklyn. Yeah, baby, go ahead.
Ronnie, what do you do to stay in shape?
Stay in shape? You must be drinking. I gained some weight. Are you kidding? It's tough to stay in a diet. Really tough. I got a big appetite. Are you kidding? Big appetite. I eat at McDonald's. I stand outside and watch the sign change. You gotta have willpower. I got no willpower. You know what willpower is with weight? Like a guy goes to the electric chair. They give him his last meal, and he stays on Weight Watchers. That's willpower. We got time here for just 30, 40 more questions, because I got nowhere to go. Anybody got a question? Go ahead.
I'd just like to say that I still think that you're one of the best.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. However, that's not a question, that's a statement. Thank you very much. Yes, dear, right over here. Right. Would you want to write that in, please? Thanks for slowing me up. That's it, folks. The end of the line. Go ahead, one more. Where'd you get a name like Rodney? My real name is Percival Sweetwater. Now, what happened was I went back into show business, you know, and I was out of it for a while. I quit. I'll give you an idea how well I was doing at the time I quit. I was the only one who knew I quit. And I saw an ad in the paper when I came back. It said, improve your personality. And I went to see the man. He told me my personality was okay, but my name was my problem. I said to him, my name? How can a name be a problem? Even William Shakespeare said, what's in a name? He said, who? I said, William Shakespeare. He said, look, want to listen to me or listen to your friends? You know the trouble with me? I'll tell you the trouble with me. I appeal to everyone who can do me absolutely no good. With me, nothing comes easy. Well, the other day, I went into McDonald's. They told me I don't deserve a break. That's the story of my life. No respect. I don't get no respect at all. Are you kidding? No respect from anyone. Are you kidding? It's not easy. Not easy. No respect at all. Well, yesterday, for 2 hours, a guy followed me with a pooper scooper. Are you kidding? Well, I held a seashell to my ear. Told me to get off the beach. I don't get no respect from anyone. I bought some rat poison. The girl asked me, should I wrap it up? I'm going to eat it here. It's not easy being me. I was arrested for jaywalking. The crowd kept yelling, don't take him alive! But I do want to acknowledge the boys behind me, the trio. They're just working together during the winter. In the spring, they're going to break up and join smaller outfits. They've been with me now for 22 years, my boys, traveling around honky towns all over the country. Over here we have my pianist, arranger, conductor, composer, and friend, Singe. And that's Buzz, he's on drums, among other things. And right behind me is my new bass man, Styles Bitchley. And Lionel, he's outside painting a bus. And this is Sonia, she don't sing, she just travels with us, that's all. Yeah, I tell you, the government's after me, back taxes. Marlene is after me, back alimony, but I'm happy, I'm using vibes again. It's too hip, too hip. Inside stuff, that's all. What do you want to do now? That's it. Show's over. You got screwed again, right? What can I tell you, huh? You want your money back, Fungo. All right, that's it. You got screwed, okay? Well, I'll tell you, the whole thing goes back to my childhood and the time I was lost on a beach and a cop came and looked for my parents. I said to the cop, you think we'll find him? He said, I don't know, kid, there's so many places they could hide. I was never lucky in a beach, never. I was drowning, I was yelling, help, help, and the lifeguard ran over. I said, all right, kid, keep it down, keep it down. My old man, he didn't help either, my old man. I was kidnapped, they sent back a piece of my finger. He said he wanted more proof. The time I asked my old man, how can I get my kite in the air? He told me to run off a cliff. What a childhood I had. My uncle's dying wish, he wanted me on his lap. He was in the electric chair. I hope you had a few laughs. Okay, watch out. Hey, good crowd, hey. This was my moment. When destiny called me, big finish, big finish. Let go of the hammer, big time. Thank you so much. Hope you had some fun. Thank you very much.